Hello, everybody. Bobby here, from Grateful Pipe and Cigar. And I decided to relax and do a little video. Let me check something here. I'm not sure my thermometer up there is very correct, but it says it's over 95 degrees. I don't think I'm buying it. Feels a little cooler than that to me, but it's still pretty warm here in Southern California. I guess it's in the 90s. It's no big deal. So I have a few things to talk with you about today. I'm gonna load a bowl of Vevet and get you a long-awaited and long-promised little review of this Vevet tobacco. Now, I'm still a relatively new pipe smoker. I've started in January of this year, so I've got just about 6 months under my belt. But I smoked cigars for a few years before that, so, you know, I'm not a complete novice to smoking anyway. And so I've been interested this whole time in not only trying all the artisan blends, all the higher end blends of tobacco, which of course I haven't gotten around to all of them. I've tried quite a few. I've got a pretty good selection here at my house now. And there's, you know, I think I've gotten around to all the different categories of tobacco, and I've had a few different over-the-counter blends, which this is one of. Definitely an over-the-counter blend, Vevet. It's a classic, as you may know. And as I've been smoking this on and off, it really has a few strong flavors in it that are very familiar. And I thought I could pick them out pretty well. And I've been thinking of showing you a comparison of these flavors in regular household items that you might have. Kitchen items, edible items, of course. So this Vevet tobacco, let me go backwards a moment and do a little tin note description. First of all, it smells the tiniest bit like alcohol, like maybe a liqueur, kind of a zing in it. But I'm smelling some chocolate, like chocolate candy. Maybe a cross between a Tootsie Roll and those little chocolate-covered cherries. I don't know what else you call them. Chocolate-covered cherries. It's not a real strong cherry flavor or cherry smell, but just that kind of overly sweet chocolate smell is what I get out of there. Plus tobacco, of course. And then when I smoke it, when I smoke it, I get the tobacco. And it's like a very decent tobacco. I wouldn't say it's a super high quality tobacco, but it certainly tastes very pleasant. But I think what that chocolate smell translates to in the smoke is something I've tried to do here. And I thought I'd try and mix something up that if you haven't purchased any Vevet, if you don't have any, you can kind of get an idea of what it's going to taste like. Now, I think I've done this once before to see if it really worked, and I actually forget how that went, but I've done it again here. So what I've done is I've made a cup of black tea, just one tea bag, regular size cup of water, six ounces, 8 ounces, not strong tea, but just black tea. I put a little bit of honey in it just to add a tiny bit of sweetness, and then to take off that bitterness of just the straight tea flavor. And then a couple of ice cubes just to get it around room temperature. And in this cup, I've got milk and some Nestle Quick, but just a little Nestle Quick. I didn't try and make a rich cup of chocolate milk here. I tried to make a very weak cup of chocolate milk. And that's what I've got. It's just a weak cup of chocolate milk. And then really what I'm missing is maybe a melted Tootsie Roll in all of this, because it has that kind of a, how a Tootsie Roll is like kind of an artificial chocolate kind of a thing going on there. And that's about what this is. All these flavors I'm talking about, they're not very strong in this tobacco. It's just like the overtones over the very basic old school tobacco flavor that's going on the whole time. But if I do that to my weak cup of chocolate milk, I think I'm getting close. Now, I guess the only thing that this is missing right here is if I had some kind of an artificial tobacco flavor, little drops that I could add to it. Now, I guess it's not a perfect comparison, but this is what I think of when I'm smoking Vevet. And maybe it just needs to be a little weaker, even. If I had a little more water here, I might add that to this as well, just to thin it out even more. Because I think that's what you're getting when you smoke Vevet. It smokes very nice. It comes a really good moisture level. It is a shag cut. I'm sure that's what you would call this. It kind of looks just torn up. It's this beautiful color, as you can see. To the touch, it feels, a bit moist. It's definitely not dry, and that works fine in the bowl. Usually I have a very hard time keeping a bowl lit while I'm talking on a video, But as you can see, I forget how many times I relit this, but I don't actually think I had to relight this after the initial relight. And it just goes. It goes and goes. It's very nice. You don't have to pay attention to it. Not too much, anyway. So I've been excited to try all the over-the-counter blends as I've progressed in my tobacco exploration. And Vevet is one of the ones that obviously comes up over and over again. So I was happy to get this 7-ounce can just to try it out. Now, I generally like all the tobaccos I try. I don't think there's a tobacco yet that I've thought to myself, oh, I don't like that. I mean, I'm a pretty agreeable guy, and I've liked pretty much every tobacco I've tried, some a lot more than others, of course. But I'm happy to have this big can of Vevet, and would I buy it again? Certainly I'll buy it again. I may not go out and make sure I have it always on hand, but it's really pleasant. The nicotine level, I'm not very sensitive to nicotine at all, so it's kind of hard for me to tell between blends what is a strong nicotine and what isn't. I would say that this is probably mild to medium nicotine. It definitely has that mellow classic flavor that I can just picture, you know, an older pipe gentleman, maybe in the 70s. I'm not sure when Vevet was first produced. I'm sure everybody's heard this information before. There, I've had to relight it. So, Vevet is produced by the Scandinavian Tobacco Group, blended by Lane. It's a Burley-based tobacco. It's got Burley and Kentucky in it. The flavoring is alcohol, liquor, and other miscellaneous. So, I kind of got that right. It's a coarse cut, maybe not a shag cut, but it says coarse cut here. Of course, it's currently available in many locations. Vevet tobacco came out in 1938. It was first manufactured by the Liggett and Myers Tobacco Company, American Can Company, in Chicago, Illinois. And, you know, it's anybody's guess if they've changed their formula at all through the years. I mean, chances are it hasn't been exactly the same, but it's definitely a pleasant smoke. If you haven't tried it, I highly recommend it. You got to try it. You know, along with your, you know, Captain Black, of course, I have not tried Prince Albert, and I have not tried Carter Hall. I still intend to try both of those. I'm looking very much forward to that. I've got some Sir Walter Raleigh. I like that a lot, and I'll talk about that sometime. You know, I've waited so long to do this review. I don't know why I've waited so long to do this review. I know that when I first got this can and the very first day I smoked this, I thought, okay, yeah, I've got to do a review on it. And I posted a tiny little YouTube short saying, review coming. But then it's been a long time. And I'm not really sure why it's taken me so long. I think I could have done this same review that day. It's not a complex smoke at all. I didn't learn anything new about it. I just learned that I knew everything I needed to know about it the first day I smoked it. and I guess that's something that I learned, right? So I guess that's all I have to say about Vevet. It's a good tobacco. I'm glad I bought such a big can, you know. I like smoking this every once in a while. In between, it's almost like a palate cleanser. In between smoking the more sought after tobaccos, the more high end tobaccos. This is great for just an afternoon that almost like I want to take an afternoon off from really paying attention to the tobacco. And so here we are. And so I guess that's it. I'm just gonna enjoy this warm summer afternoon. Probably sit out here and smoke a couple more bowls and relax. So I hope you all have a good day. And if you want God's blessing, find out who God is. And in that, you will be blessed. Have a good day, my friends.